But wait, what's this? A furry feel? I'm turning into a werewolf, it's surreal. Moonlit shift, a crazy scene. A werewolf girl behind the screen. Flipping burgers, serving fries. The secret life under starry skies.
You'll do fine, Lena, Larry said, not looking up from his comic book. His voice was a gentle rumble in the small, cluttered room. It's just a fast food joint, not the moonlit battleground of Resident Solo.
Lena couldn't help but chuckle nervously at the reference to her favorite show, Resident Lone Wolf. Larry had a knack for picking the cheesiest lines from the most epic scenes and using them in everyday situations. It was his way of lightening the mood, she knew, but her stomach was doing backflips. Tonight was her first shift at Beast Buy, burgers and fries. The streetlights cast an eerie glow as she stepped out into the night. The air was cooler than she had expected, carrying a faint scent of rain and the distant sound of sirens. She shivered and tugged at her too tight work apron. It was going to be a long night. Her eyes fell on a small figure huddled in the shadows. It was a wolf pup, no bigger than a kitten, with fur the color of midnight. It had large, round eyes that gleamed with curiosity as it watched her approach. Lena's heart melted. She had always loved animals. "Hey there, little guy," she whispered, extending a gentle hand. The pup's tail wagged tentatively before it lunged forward, nipping at her finger. Lena yelped in surprise as she felt a sharp sting. She yanked her hand back and stared at the tiny droplet of blood welling up. The pup's eyes grew wide with what she could only interpret as apology, and it bolted away, disappearing into the night. Her drive was uneventful at first, filled with the monotonous honking of car horns as the street lights illuminated the road ahead. Then she noticed the full moon in the car window, and things grew strange. Her skin grew itchy, and she could feel her body stretching in ways that made her gasp. Panic bubbled in her chest as her reflection in the rear-view mirror grew hairier, her eyes glowing a fiery amber. Pulling over, Lena fumbled with the door handle, her hands morphing into furry paws. She stepped out of the car and her legs gave way beneath her, transforming into powerful haunches. The world around her took on a new dimension, sounds heightened and smells more potent. The asphalt was now a sea of scents telling tales of the night's events. She tried to keep calm, to fight the transformation, but it was too late. Her body grew, stretching into a sleek and voluptuous werewolf form. Her eyes remained her own, filled with a mix of horror and fascination as she took in her reflection in a puddle. The fur that now covered her was as black as her hair had been, and her human clothes lay in tatters around her. The tight Beast Buy apron had somehow remained intact, clinging to her new, curvy frame. The myth that the mind of a werewolf becomes consumed by the beast during the transformation was a comforting lie. Lena was still very much herself, just furrier. She felt a strange sense of relief, despite the shock of her new reality. The legends had painted a picture of mindless rage and savagery, but she remained coherent. With trembling paws, she fumbled her phone out of the pocket of her ruined jeans. It was a miracle the device had survived the shift. She dialed Larry's number with a sense of urgency.
"Yo, sis, everything okay?" Larry said over the phone. His voice was a lifeline in the chaos of her transformation.
"I'm fine," Lena said, trying to stay calm. "I need you to bring one of my spare work uniforms from my closet and bring it to me at the alley on the corner of 79th and Main. And please promise me you won't scream."
"Lena, you know me, I'm cooler than a cucumber in a snowstorm," Larry said, his tone reassuring despite the hint of concern. "But why the alley?"
"Don't ask questions you don't want the answers to," Lena shyly remarks. "Just get here, and soon." The wait felt like an eternity, but finally, Larry's bike came into view. He parked haphazardly and walked in, bag in hand. The moment he saw her, his eyes bulged and his
"Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god!"
Without dropped him face first into her now massive, fur-covered chest. The fabric of her apron strained against her new form, and she could feel Larry's body convulsing with shock against her. "It's okay, Larry," she said soothingly, her voice a mix of her own and the gruff rumble of a wolf. "It's still me. Just, you know, with more fur."
Larry took a deep breath and nodded, his cheek still pressed against her furry chest. I know," he stammered. "But you're so dead."
Lena couldn't help but blush, even with fur. "It's the transformation," she mumbled, stepping back to give him some space. "But we don't have time for this. I need to get to work."
Larry nodded, his eyes darting around the alley as he handed over the bag. "Here, I brought your spare." He paused, taking in her new form. I'll give you some privacy."
Lena nodded gratefully and retreated into the shadowy recesses of the alley. The fabric of the new uniform was surprisingly stretchy, but it was clear she'd need some improvisation. Her claws danced over the remnants of her old clothes, snipping and tearing with surprising dexterity. The torn pieces of her jeans and shirt were no match for her sharp teeth, and she worked quickly, stitching the fabric together with a makeshift needle she'd fashioned from a piece of wire she'd found in the alley.
Larry's eyes widened as he watched her work, a mix of awe and horror. He had always known Lena was resourceful, but seeing her tailor a uniform while in her werewolf form was something else entirely. "I can't believe you're doing that," he murmured, his voice a mix of admiration and fear.
"It's a good thing we both know how to sew,"
Lena said, her voice muffled by the fabric she held in her teeth. She had managed to fix up a makeshift uniform without further damage to the apron, which was now the only piece of her original outfit that still fit. "Thanks for the clothes, by the way."
Larry nodded, his cheeks still flushed from his earlier scream. He watched as she deftly wove the material of her old shirt into the new one, creating a makeshift neckline that would accommodate her new enhancements. "No problem," he said, his voice still a little shaky. "So, tell me what happened. Did you get bit by a
wolf? Well, sort of. A wolf pup came up and nicked my hand then ran off," Lena said as she finesses the now werewolf-sized uniform. "I was driving when the transformation started. One second it was calm, the next I'm in an alleyway as fur grows and my body grew."
As Lena puts on her newly made uniform, Larry's expression shifted from fear to excitement, realizing he now has a werewolf for a sister. "Whoa, Lena, you look amazing." He couldn't help but stare.
Lena rolls her eyes and tells Larry to not tell anyone as she uses her agility to run through the back lease to work. Lena arrived at Beast Buy, her heart racing. The neon lights cast a garish glow over the parking lot, and she could hear the distant clanging of kitchen equipment and the murmur of customers. She slipped in through the back door, hoping to avoid any unnecessary attention. But fate had other plans.
"Hey, you! Yes, you in the wolf fursuit," said a middle-aged Asian-American man from behind her. It was Mr. James T. Hong, her boss. "You're Lena Lupin, right?" he said with a grin that seemed to stretch from ear to ear.
"Yes. Can I help you, sir?" Lena replied in a nervous tone, like she was bracing for impact during a train crash.
Mr. Hong's eyes lit up like Christmas lights. "Oh, you're perfect. Just in time for our grand opening." He grabbed her arm and practically dragged her to the front of the restaurant. "Our mascot didn't show up, and you look just like our logo," he said, pointing to the logo, which looks like a black cartoon wolf happily eating a cheeseburger. "You're hired." And that is how Lena Lupin became the minimum wage werewolf.